It always blew my mind how some developers could simply sit down and write code for hours on end. I wanted to be that developer. I wanted to be the guy who just sat down and churned out code for 8 hours a day. Well, it turned out that the reality is a little bit different. This video is sponsored by me. If you want to have a mentor, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring. Let's meet on a Zoom call and find out your bugs or learn Swift UI. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now let's get back into the video and learn how I write code with hours on end without taking a break. Before I get into the 12 tips that I like to use to code for hours on end, let me ask you this question. Do you really want to code for hours and hours without any breaks? Well, if the question is yes, then most probably you want to do this because you want to get into the state of flow. Now, if you don't know what the state of flow is, well, that is something that has been introduced by Mihai Csikszentmihalyi, and yes, that is how it is pronounced. Well, actually, in Hungarian, it's the other way around. The first name and last name are kind of reversed. It's Csikszentmihalyi, Mihai, but anyway. The flow has been introduced by Mihai Csikszentmihalyi, and it's kind of like, think of it like you are indistractable, you are in the state of flow. Most probably you already been there, but you didn't really realize it. And this could take from 12 minutes or up to 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours long. It all depends on how easy or often are you distracted. So if you do want to code for hours, make sure that you check out Mihai Csikszentmihalyi's book. It's called Flow, and you will learn a lot more about that and why it's so beneficial to work in the state of work. Basically, I do want to get into the state of work, so here are my 12 tips and tricks. First of all, number 12 is find your 6 hours in the day. Now, as much as we'd like to code for more than 6 hours, let's say 8, 10, 12 hours, it's basically impossible to do that in a state of flow. Basically, maybe you are in the front of your computer for 10 hours, but active work will not be more than 6 hours. 6 hours is kind of the most that I can think of being in that state of flow, being really productive. Now, you want to find these 6 hours. It could be one chunk, so it should be just, I don't know, from 10 a.m. till 4 p.m., but you could just chunk it out throughout your day. It could be 1 hour in the morning or 3 hours in the morning, then 3 hours in the evening. It all depends on your schedule. Or, of course, if you're an employer, then you might want to put these 6 hours into your day work. Now, that is how you start off. You want to get your schedule up. You want to know when you are coding. And that's because when you just do this over and over again, it becomes a habit. Therefore, you will sit down much more easily and you will get into that state of flow. So habits are really important to start this state of flow. Number 11 is this one. Get blue light glasses. I couldn't tell you more enough how much I love these glasses. It does have some blue light shield. Of course, that comes from my computer, and it's making my eyes really, really like it doesn't bother my eyes that much as if I wouldn't have this. Of course, these are subscription glasses, so yeah, I just put them on. But if you don't wear glasses, go ahead and buy a glass. It's like a sunglasses, but for a blue light. Your eyes will thank me later. Number 10. Have your water at your desk. Now, this is really important because you want or will sit at your computer for hours on end. You don't really want to get up and get a sip of water or get a glass of water. Now, what you can do is bring your water with you so you stay hydrated. And of course, staying hydrated is really, really important because, yeah, that's what we all do all day long. We just sit at the computer, and most probably you don't drink as much water as you should. Number 9, get a comfortable chair. Now, I'm using Variable. It's the original kneeling chair. It's really, really amazing. It helps me balance my posture. It doesn't hurt my back. So after I switched to this really, really amazing chair, it's really strange, but it is really amazing for my back. I never turned back. Number 8, stand up every 30 minutes and walk around for a few minutes. Now, this is kind of counterintuitive, because if you are in a state of flow, then you don't want to interrupt yourself. Well, that's okay, but once you see that you are getting out of that flow, so you get a little bit distracted by some noise or something else, then do get up, at least in the 50 minutes period. Why is that? Well, because you do want to exercise a little bit, like not exercise, but just move around. You don't want to sit those 6 hours all day long. Number 7, set do not disturb on. Now, I mean it. Set do not disturb on and on all of your devices, be it your phone, of course, because we are constantly taking a look, testing on our phone. Also set your do not disturb on your phone and also on your computer. It will help you quite a lot. And of course, if a notification comes in, then your flow state is really, really like messed up. So you don't want to do that. You want to avoid distraction at all costs. Do not disturb is a really a good way of doing that. Number 6, shortcuts. Now I use Command Tab or Shift Command Tab quite a lot because I have a small screen. It's just one laptop. I don't have those large curved screens or extra monitors. And therefore, if I use, and most probably you too use, a lot of tabs, a lot of open windows, then just use Command Tab, or if you want to go back, Shift Command Tab. It will save you a ton of time and a ton of frustration of moving between windows. Also, on the shortcut side, I use Command Space quite a lot to open up Spotlight, so I can just search for, let's say, a project or another file that I'm looking for, maybe an image or something like that. Command Space. So Command Tab for switching between windows and Command Space for searching. Number 5, now this is a game changer, dark mode. Enable dark mode on your computer. It will change the way that you look at your computer and it will change the way you code forever. Now, I had dark mode enabled for ages. Even when we didn't have dark mode, I tried to do a theme for all of my project, let's say Xcode, or if it was possible, I tried to do a dark mode whenever I could, because that white light, it hurts my eye. I cannot do it. So dark mode. Number 4, if you are on a dark mode, then you would definitely want to have for Xcode, I do have a dark theme. It's called Rebeloper One Dark Theme. And with that comes a Firacode font. Go ahead and check it out. I do have a separate video on how to use that. It's free of use and it is really, really like coder-like. I really like it. Go ahead and check out the video. The video will be linked down in the description. Number 3, another Xcode hint. Hide the canvas, hide the inspectors, and sometimes hide the navigation tab also. Because you want to code, so any other space that might distract you or doesn't have any real application should be taken away. All I have now is just the code and the code only. So I hide all of the other stuff. Also on Xcode, number 2, use the built-in source control. Now, this is really amazing about Xcode. It has GitHub already built in, so it's really, really straightforward and easy to use. I just go up and source code, commit, source code push, or source code pull. It's really, really amazing, and it's a time saver. And of course, if you don't want to get out of your state of flow, then you want to make these optimizations also. And finally, my number 1, go ahead and do not listen to music that has lyrics in it. So usually I just go ahead and add a lo-fi playlist, or if I don't want to listen to music, I just use Noisly, a background sound generator, or I just add in some white noise. Again, it's a lo-fi playlist, or if I want to not listen to any music at all because I need to concentrate that much, I just use Noisly. Now, what if you don't have 6 uninterrupted hours that you can code in? Now, that may be the case because maybe you're working from home, maybe you just have 1 hour at the office or 2 hours uninterrupted space for yourself. Well, There's a solution for that, and that is what I like to call the 5-minute developer. If you have 5 minutes, maybe 10 minutes or 15 minutes, go ahead and sit down at your desk. Make sure that it's on the same desk, and of course, bring your bottle of water, and make sure that you make a habit out of it. That is the really important part here, because if it's a habit, then you are going to get into that state of flow really, really quickly, even if it's 5 minutes. In 5 minutes, you can do a lot if you do it each and every day or even multiple times per day. Now, if you did like these 12 tips and tricks on how you can get into the state of flow and code for hours, then most probably you will love my other video where I talk about the 10 one-liners in Swift UI that will blow your mind. Go ahead and check it out. It's right over here.